Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look at buildpacks.io. If you're sick and tired of creating your own Dockerfiles, then this is just something for you, because what it does is it adds an abstraction layer to our existing to our Dockerfile. So actually, we do not need to create a Dockerfile. We just need to create our application, and then a builder will actually figure out how should this be built and how should it be packed, and what do we want to start up when we start our application. It sounds like magic. It is almost magic, but it is awesome. Let me say that already. It supports a lot of different applications. It supports Java and Node applications. There's a lot of different applications. But what I'm going to focus on tonight is a Spring Boot application built with Maven. And that means that if I place myself in the root folder and I have a pump.xml file in that root folder, then Buildpack's pack utility actually can figure out how to pack this application. I need to choose a builder, because there's multiple standards, or multiple builders actually. The Google has made a builder, and also Heroku has made a builder, and it's actually Heroku who started this Buildpack's projects in, it was actually spawned, I think, in 2011, and then some other joined in 2018. At right now, it has gotten some traction. It has actually gotten so much traction that Spring actually supports Buildpack in that version 2.3. There's actually a goal that can be run, build image, so we can actually use Buildpack by running a Maven command. But first of all, of course, we need the utility if we want to install, if we want to create a Docker image locally on our own machine. But else, the idea is actually that when we upload our code, then some cloud platform can actually take this code, and then we can just say, put it into production, or put it into development environment, or put it into a staging environment, and then through the Buildpack's builder engine, or the chosen builder engine that we choose, then the cloud platform can actually set everything up for you and just spawn a development environment. Right now, it actually uses Docker. That means that we will actually get a Docker image when we run pack. Pack build, then we will get a Docker image. But in the future, we might get some other technologies, because it supports this OCI standard. And if we go look this OCI standard up right here, it stands for Open Container Initiative right here. And we can actually see here in the end, it actually says, and it is blah 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 as a Docker replacement. So it's actually also working on something called RunC, which is a container runtime. That could be a Docker replacement. But right now, it creates a Docker image. So my first feeling when I just ran this is actually the same feeling that when I went from Ant to Maven. That of course I miss my Dockerfile. I would like to tweak a lot of stuff, but it is just so easy to create an image with this Buildpack, and it does it beautifully. And we can also add environment variables like this. I can just write pack build, and then the name of my application. This will actually be the Docker image name that I have right here. This is the syntax, and then I can write -- environment. And I need this because I want to choose to build with Java 14. This didn't give me any problem with the Google builder. Then I could just write Java runtime 14, and it actually worked as an environment variable. When I used Heroku, then I got some problems. It was actually not possible, because there was no JDK URL for 14. If I chose JDK 11, there was no problem with Heroku. So, but that is just my experience for tonight. If you have other experiences, just place them in the comments. This is just an get up and running video. So Heroku, our Buildpack. So the first thing we need to do, of course, is that we actually need to install. We can install a pack CLI, which they also say right here. The fastest way to try it out is to try the pack CLI, and that's a good tutorial right here. Then the first thing we need to do is install pack. And first we need Docker. So first we need Docker for this to run right now. And then the next thing is that if we're using Linux, which I am, then I could just run wget and then this tarball right here, unpack the tarball, and then remove the tarball and then run pack something. And that is exactly what I did. I did one more thing actually. I placed a symbolic link in the user in the user bin folder to pack, and so that means that then I can run pack from where I want to. And they actually also said here you can actually copy the file if you want to copy the executable. I made a symbolic link. I like symbolic links better because then I can replace my my executable later on. But enough talk. I'm almost boring you now. I know that you're almost bored. So let us look at some code and let us look at what's actually happening. I have a project right here. This is my graceful shutdown demo that I showed you yesterday, and I do not have a Dockerfile for this project. And of course, my usual approach would be to create a multi-stage Docker build file, Dockerfile, and then I would actually build my application and then I would make it run. But I do not want to do that tonight. Instead, I want to use Buildpack. So what I do is I go to a terminal instead. Let me just clear the screen right here. And I have I'm in the same folder as my pump.xml file. This is quite important. And then I can run commands like this, pack build my graceful application. And then I can give an environment variable, my Google runtime version 14. And then I can choose the builder. And you can see the builder that I'm choosing right here, right now, that is Google GCR.io build packs builder. Where did I get that from? Did I just invent that? Did I just write that? I guessed that. No, I did not just guess that, because there is something called suggested builders. So if I write pack and then space suggested builders like this, did I misspell it? Let me just did you mean suggest build? Yes, it's not suggested, just suggest builders. Then actually pack will actually say we have these builders that you can use. Here we have the Google one. That's the one I used. And this is the one which gave me the least trouble. And this is probably the one I would use. But if you're using Heroku to control all of your environments, then of course you might, then of course you should use Heroku instead. And I made my application run with both builders, but with Heroku, I had to downgrade my Java version to 11 in my pump.xml file. I have this pump.xml file right here. And somewhere in here it says Java version something. I had to change this to 11 to make it work with Heroku. Heroku also has another thing. If you want to reduce Heroku, you actually need to create this system.properties file. So this system.properties file, I think this is a little bit ugly. I would like just to add an environment variable. And look here, I choose a Java version. If I set this to 14, then I got the JDK UL not found error. But now let's get to it. So the first thing, let us run the pack commands. Now you know how I got the builder, but this is the syntax. I need to give a builder right here. And I got the builder from suggest builders. And I need to set the runtime. I'm setting this to 14. It still works, even though my application right now is targeting 11. So it just needs to be newer than the pump, the Java version in the pump file. So we have pack build my graceful app one, and I want to use the same name as I've already built, because it takes quite a long time to build it all the first time. So right now I'll just run it, and then we'll see that there's not many changes from the last build, which I just made like 10 minutes ago or something like that. Image is up to date, blah, 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 blah. And then it's detecting and it's analyzing, it's restoring, it's building. And here you can see it actually gets it uses Java 14. And then it runs, it uses Maven Wrapper also, just so you know, it uses Maven Wrapper, of course it does. It's a good build tool, right? So it uses the Maven Wrapper, and then it compiles all the code. And then it's done, and it says successfully built my graceful app 1. Let us try to say Docker images, just to look at what it actually created. My graceful app 1, look, it is right here. My first thought when I saw this was actually, okay, it created the app. Of course, my first thing was, does it work? But yes, let me just spoil it to you. It works, but I will run it in just a minute. I just want to show it to you. There are two things that confuse me a bit. Why does it say 40 years ago? There's something wrong with the build timestamp, right? Yeah. So I guess they will work on that. The other thing is 493 megabytes on this kind of application. Let me just show you what I built with if I use Alpine, and if I use my own custom Dockerfile, then I go to 214 megabyte, and I could actually tweak this even a bit more. I think I forgot to delete a tar file or something like that, but this project actually right here is a Spring Boot application, and while including a view application, so it's actually two applications. So if I deleted the view application, then of course I would have a little bit more space. It was not a huge view application, but I think it's a little bit too big. I didn't like the size. Another thing is, when I built the same application with Heroku, then it took almost 700 megabytes. Yeah, but that is why I would definitely prefer the Google way. But I really like the OCI thought that we do not need to create a Dockerfile every time, because these applications, they are going to, yeah, they're doing the same, right? And the OCI also, the builder, they should enforce some security and some stuff like that, and they have upgraded all the packages to some they have much more developers than I'm just one person. So when I am creating my Docker multi-stage build, then I hope that the Alpine actually works and there's no security flaws in it or something like that. But I guess when Google or Heroku, they have an army of developers, I guess, that can check if their builder creates secure images. Now I'm just guessing, but that should be one of the purposes also for using a standardized tool like Buildpack, that we have some other people that looks at the builder and looks at how to create the images, because that's not our concern. Our concern is to create application and integrations so we need to create business value, right? That is what we should do. If you're a full stack developer, of course, then you're also interested in Docker, and we need to know a little bit so we can run locally on our own machines. Enough talk. Let us run this Docker image right here. Docker minus IT, Docker run minus IT, and then my graceful app one like this. Minus IT blah 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 blah, and then I want to expose a port 8080, port 8080 right here. And let us run the application. Oh, okay. Sorry, yeah, I have to write that before the name of the image. So my graceful app one like this. And it starts up. It's really, really cool. It's awesome. And how does it detect this, you might think? But there's a pump.xml file, right? Which actually says which file should actually be started up. So, and of course, the builders, they also know the standard application that are out there, including Spring Boot, of course. But But that's also that is why the pump.xml file is important for the build pack to work. But let us run some requests against this, because yesterday when I showed you the graceful shutdown, then I created a REST controller. Let us just go look space REST controller right here. I created the REST controller that sleeps for 10 seconds and then it returns true. Yes, I am sorry, I have not changed the code. So now we need to wait 10 seconds for this curl here to run. And as you can actually see, let me just clear buffer. And close other tabs like this. So it says swoosh after 10 seconds like this. Let me just run again, because I was doing a lot of things as usual while demonstrating this endpoint right here. If you're interested, I've placed some under a script pack. I will commit and push this code as usual. Then I've placed some code, some scripts under pack. You can use those. Build Google. This is this is how I built with Google, and build Heroku. This is how I built with Heroku. I will also commit the system.properties. Then I suggest a builder, which is right there. Remember, if you want to run this, you need to either run from IntelliJ, because that will set the default path to the application path. That will be root path, and then pack can then find the pump.xml file. If you run from a terminal, you need to be placed under in the root application folder, so in the same folder as the pump.xml file. I'll also commit and push the system.properties file here. Then you can play with it and try to see if you somehow can make make Java 14 work with Heroku, and I doubt it. But let me know if you know better than me. But the application was actually up and running. That's fine. It returns whoosh. Let me shut down the application like this. I'll shut it down, and then I'll try again just so you can actually see that it was not something I just that I'm not lying. So that's it. Buildpack. It is awesome. That was some more thing. One more thing. When you're building with Buildpack, then you want some help, then you need to go to the builder. So right now you can see here we have Google Cloud Platform, then we have Buildpacks, and then you can actually see all the documentation here. And that's how I figured out that I could actually use. I could set the Java version somewhere down here. Yeah, it actually says the Google runtime version. So that is how I found that. So you need to go to the builder websites for the build packs, and Heroku has the documentation right here. And that's also how I knew that I could actually just place the Java version in the system.properties, because it actually started with Java 8 per default. So of course I had to create the system.properties file. I think it's I don't like it, but maybe I don't know. I think it's a little bit, I don't like to have third party specific files along with my source code in my project. I do not like that at all. I like to have an environment variable just like Google made it, because then I can place that environment variable where I want to place it. But that's it. Thank you very much. I think you can find all of these URLs, right? So it's buildpack.io, and if you search for Google Cloud Platform and Buildpack, then you can also find this page, and Heroku and Buildpacks, then you will also find this web page right here. Thank you very much for watching. I think this is awesome. Have a great evening. Hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.